very much a kind of very broad-based democratic process in some ways, right? So it is selected by the faculty, it's voted on, the vote is on members in good standing, because you have to be in good standing in NHS, and who have a, and this is where we cut out some folks, a 4.0 unweighted cumulative GPA, and demonstrate the pillars of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. Now, I gotta tell you, there's some of you that maybe because you're not a four, you're sitting here going, man, this I'm out of the right now. You're not a slacker. I graduated from high school with, I will tell you, a 3.65. I was a good student. But I was a 4.0 student. And today, just for the moment, we're gonna recognize somebody with just that tippy, tippy top. The people, you know, it's one of these, it's among the critical of crap. This is the very thin strata, the thinnest layer of people that have just every single day brought that great excellence. So 4.0 on the GPA. All right, so I'm gonna ask the following person to join me here because I want to embarrass them. Michael. Wood. Asia Forzak, please join me. I think I know Asia. I think you had her in your class. I think you've been jealous of her intelligence.
Asia, I'm so glad you're here. Let me
take a minute.
You know what the criteria is at this point. Let me give you a few words of what your teacher said to you about you, okay?
Mr. Murphy had this to say. Asia is a most conscientious young lady, always keeping on top of assignments and working to complete each assignment with excellence. She is a committed NHS member. She actively supports THS by providing academic tutoring in the ELL program. Thank you. That's part of it, because there's a kids you can actually get those things. You work at it, but you can actually get it. These are students who struggle with basic things. She, in the ELL program, assisting with freshman orientation.
but it's time for the president's speech. Everyone take